This is Anita from Swedish Crafts, and today I'm going to try and vectorize one of the drawings that I made using Silhouette Studio 4.1. So I've just opened Silhouettes and I'm trying new desktop recording software. Now I'm just going to drag and drop the drawing that I want to vectorize into Silhouettes, and it starts loading, and then we wait. There we go. Might have to zoom out a little bit. So this is a drawing that I made. I totally made it myself, and I'm going to rescale it a bit. And I'm going to zoom in again. There. So now I'm going to click the tracing window, select trace area, select everything that I want to have traced. And then we're going to be playing around with the settings a bit to see if we can make it as nice as possible. So if you put the threshold too high, it will just do everything. If you put it too low, it will not trace anything at all. So for reference, everything that is yellow here will be traced. So if you use the high pass, everything will get yellow again. And if you use the low pass, nothing will get yellow. Then I click on trace, and now it should be traced. And here you see the trace that it made. I want to totally vectorize it myself to make sure that everything is the way I want it to be. So I'm going to try and see if it works, because for some reason this is always a very tricky part for me. To make things a little bit easier, I'm going to give her a little bit of color, because then I can see if I have the right one selected, which I don't. So I'm using Ctrl Z, by the way, to undo anything that I did. So it should be this one. And nothing's happening. How about now? Yeah, write this. Like this. Yeah, only I didn't. Third time's the charm, right? So if I do it now, now you can see all the little points for the vectorization. I'm just going to be zooming in and working on all of these one at a time. First, I'm going to put the transparency down of my blues so that I can see what I'm doing a little bit better. I'll just start off with her hair. Zooming in quite a bit, and then I'm going to take each point and I'm going to make it exactly how I actually want it to be. So this one you can see is the S curve, and I want it to be a sharp curve. So I'm just going to select that, and then I'm going to move these so that it will form a sharp curve like I want it to. Now I'm just going to be playing around with these until I get what I want. I'm going to be removing the majority of the factorization points because, well, I don't actually need them if I play around with these to get the right angles and shapes that I want. And that is basically what I am going to do for the entire picture. I myself have noticed there's no actual real right or wrong way to do this. I'm just attempting to recreate the same result using the least amount of points that I can. So the scan we made is actually as high resolution as we could. So here you can see that the factorization has made a little mistake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break these two points, and then I'm going to take this one, place it here, and I'm going to break these two points. Connect these, and we're going to connect these, and that should fix that right up. So I skipped ahead a bit because I didn't want to bore you guys to death. Here you can see my mermaid's eye. It's a bit of a mess, so I'm going to attempt to fix it, and well, talk you guys through how I do that. So this happens to me a lot, so I'll just do Control Z. So I'm going to be breaking this point again. Control Z. Ah, well, there we go. Put that one over there for now. Let me see. I'm going to break this one off as well. And I'm going to connect these two. And I'm going to connect these two. Placing this one in the corner right here. Making it a nice curve. This one in the corner over here, and to remove that one, pressing the delete key, putting this one over here. So these are in fact her eyelashes, or that's what they're supposed to be. But as you can see, silhouette tends to get the edges wrong. Now I'm going to try and remove this one entirely. So theoretically we could make this arch with just two points. So I'm going to remove this one. And now we just have to reposition this one and this one until we get the arch that we want. Well, it is looking a little bit better, but I am going to just click here on the line, and by this way I'm adding another point, dragging it to here, because your actual eyelet extends right here and these are the eyelashes, so I'm going to try and mimic that a little bit. So this is a lash that actually goes right here, so I'm going to try and mimic that a little bit more. Maybe I should do that by adding another point here. Making it a corner. Like so. So this project is becoming a little bit bigger than I thought. Before I continue, I'm going to try something else. It's this one. Basically, it should simplify the vector and reduce the amount of dots. Well, it reduced the amount of dots, alright. So now I just need to go and check if my lines are still remotely okay. Well, there clearly are fewer lines, but it looks like I will have to redo the entire image. Basically, nearly everything that I've already done, I need to go and recheck. So I'm going to do that now. So now that our mermaid is done, I want to move on to the air bubbles. She blows. And for this, I am going to try and just make new air bubbles. I think that will be easier than doing all these by hand. So I'm making two circles, trying to align them. Then I will try and select them both and group them, but only them. There we go. I'm first going to try and see if I can remove the bubbles here. Now I'm going to skip this part and I'll get back to you when I've removed all of the bubbles. So I figured out how to massively remove them. I've got one selected, and if I do shift now, I can just do select all of them. So while holding shift down, I can select all of these and then I can delete them all at once. So now I'm going to take my circle and I'm just going to place it here. And then I'm going to duplicate it and place it here. I guess there is a button here for duplication as well. Well, I'm going to do the big bubbles first and I'm going to make another template for the smaller ones. So I'm selecting these two and ungrouping them. I want to have just the smaller part, or actually I'm going to take the bigger one. I'm going to scale it down and place that in the middle. Scale it down some more. And then I'm going to take both of them again. Group them. And I'll use this one for the template for the little bubbles. So now I'm going to try and select all of these. Without selecting the background image, so I used shift and selecting the background image again to unselect it, and I'm going to, well, I wanted to group, but apparently you can't. I guess I didn't select it, so I'm going to group. I think I've left one out, so select all, shift unselect the background and group. So now that I have my drawing entirely vectorized, I'm going to remove the background and I want to add some text. Well, this is it for the tutorial, guys. I hope it's useful for you. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up. I might make more tutorial videos like this in the future. If I have more silhouette projects, if you want to see those or other projects that I'm working on, please subscribe to my channel and I hope to see you next time. Bye!